Hi everyone, welcome to the Prince of Technical channel. In the multi-threading tutorial series, today we are going to start with a runnable interface. So as we discussed in the first part one, that there are two types of things are there to take the multi-threading concept in Java. That is, one is class, one is interface. Class is nothing but we have to extend the thread class, and second we are having runnable interface. So first, what exactly the runnable interface and how it works, that we have to understand. So first of all, we are having the diagram like this. First we will have the runnable interface. This class detail is coming into the thread class. Now whatever we write, runnable interface is having one method, that is start. This runnable interface is coming into the thread. So what it is doing, it has overrided the which method, start method here. Plus here in the thread class we are having totally two methods. Here we are having start method, which is abstract method, and then here we will have like start method. Sorry guys, here it is not a start method, sorry for this. Here we have to write run method. So here my method will be run method, because runnable interface will have only one method, and that is run method. Here we will have the two methods, that is, one is start method and one is, so here I will have start method and the second one is run method. So these are the method. Now till now we have only extended the thread class, but now we are going to take the runnable interface. Now how we have to do it, just observe here. Suppose let us say I am taking class as th demo 7, nothing but thread demo 7. This is the 7th program, implements runnable. So previously what we were doing, we were writing only extend thread, but now I am writing implements runnable. Now here we have to learn the few points that I wanted to show you. Just let me first write this threadmin 7. Here I will write public static void main. I will just include all the codes. I wanted to show few points here before going to the further. So I will save it, and we have to create the object of ts demo 7. T is equals to new th demo 7. Now guys, here one thing is what, when we were extending the thread class, writing run method was mandatory or optional there? It was a optional. Why? Because it was coming from the thread class. In the thread class, they have already overrided that method. Okay. So in that situation, what we have to do, that there it was optional, but now here, because it is a interface method, and you know that interface method means compulsory you have to override that method. So I have to write public void run. So this point is very important here. Suppose somebody asks you, writing run method is optional or mandatory if we extend the thread class? So there it was optional. If you do not write anything into that one, it was calling the thread class method. But here, as it is a runnable interface, if somebody asks you, is it mandatory or optional? So compulsory, what should be your answer? It is mandatory to override the run method. Now whatever the logic you want to write, you can write here. Let us say I am writing that same, whatever the logic we follow from the first program, that same logic will write integer I is equals to 1, I less than or equals to 10, I plus plus, and here we'll write system dot out dot println, and I wanted to print like child class. Okay. Now this is run method is done. Now sir, how to call from here? So generally what happened, we were calling like this t dot start. But now you tell me, how many methods are available in the runnable interface? There is only one method is available. Now if I call the start, what you will get? You will get immediately error that start method is not available in the ts demo 7. If you want to see, first we will see the output of this one. I will write th main 7.java, and I will save this into our folder where we are saving our all files, that is PR softwares folder. So let me save this file. Go to the command prompt, drive java c, sorry, first PR software is a folder. So we have to go to our folder, java c, our file name is th main 7.java. okay, so we are getting one error. What is showing? Cannot find a symbol start. Means what? Here what we learn here is we can't access the start method now because it is not in the thread class. But already we know, if I call directly, let us say, now if we call the run method, is it a multi-threading or normal program, guys? If I call directly run method, it is a normal program. If you wanted to see, I will write the code inside the same code for loop. I will write the main also. Already, I hope, guys, those who are new to this runnable interface, first time if you are watching, I will suggest you please watch my other videos so that it will be a little easy for you. Okay, you will find the links in the description also about the other videos. So let us say now here thread will be created or not. How will you get to know? Just depends on the output. If you are getting first is child, and then if you are getting the main, because I have to change here main, then only will understand whether main is executing or child. So if you are getting child first and main after that, so it definitely meaning is what? You are not getting the multi-threading concept there. So first observe child first and then main. If you execute any number of time, output is same only. So this is not a multi-threading. So multi-threading means what? Compulsory you have to call what? Start method only, then only second thread will be threaded. So if you want to do that one, then you have to create a thread class object, because in the thread class only the start method is available. So I will write t1 is equals to new thread. Now inside the thread I will pass the object of t, nothing but this class object I am passing inside what? Thread class. Now I can call t1.run, because t1 is available in which class? T1 is nothing but which class, guys? Thread class. So in the thread class we are having which method? Start method. So we are calling start method, but indirectly we are passing reference of what? T. So nothing but what? This run method will be called. So what is happening here? Because we are passing the reference of T, so it will call the T. When we are called the t1.start, indirectly it will pass the reference of T and run method will be executed. Now two threads will be created in this situation. Just observe your first output, then we'll discuss few more points here. Okay, semicolon is missing here. Let me write the semicolon. Okay, now see, main is coming first, then child, then main child mix output will be mixed. Obviously it is a now multi-threading, we got it. So what you have to remember, whenever we are using the runnable interface, the point number one, we can't suppose example, let us say first I will show you, I'm not overriding run method, I give name as run1. See, immediately you will get a error here. Error, not run is a not abstract and does not override which method? Run method. So writing run method is mandatory or optional, guys? It is mandatory. Point number two, when we use the runnable interface, it is compulsory that you have to create the object of thread class, and in that only you have to pass your object, then only it is possible to call that concept. Now you will get a question, sir, which one is more suitable, whether runnable or thread? So always we prefer runnable. The reason behind that, that run method you have to call mandatory, it is there optional. There are some few points, everybody will say their own points, but these are the major points you have to remember. I hope you got the clarity on the runnable interface. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you for watching this video, guys.